And I was in disbelief today because they agreed to host me for a signing on Sunday. And then the owner of the bookstore called and said, because he didn't agree with my opinions in the book, even though he hadn't read the book, he was canceling the event. Now, he has the right to do whatever he wants. It's his business. But what kind of world are we living in right now where owners of independent bookstores get so triggered by the idea that someone might have a different opinion than they do that they cancel a public book signing? It's not like they're paying me anything. This is only profitable for them. The only reason I would do it is to be able to go see people and have them come get an autographed copy of my book. I make no money from doing this. This is just entirely me gifting to that bookstore my presence and probably thousands of dollars in additional book sales for them from my book. Because over the course of, I mean, it's easy. Over the course of the next month, if I sign a bunch of books for him, first of all, there might be 100 people who show up and buy my book that day. That wouldn't stun me because there's going to be a big crowd of people down on the beach there. It wouldn't stun me if 100 people show up. That's thousands of dollars in revenue for his independent bookstore. He's basically getting me there 100% for free. I'm giving him my labor for free. And so if he had decided he didn't want to host my event, I would have perfectly understood. There might be other events going on. It might be that he doesn't want to have an author that day. There are lots of reasons he could have made up. But instead, he flat out said that the reason why he wouldn't host a book signing for me, despite the fact that he had not read my book, was because he disagreed with some of my opinions. I should say I'm in disbelief, but this is the world we live in now, where everything has to be political, where it is impossible for you to step into a bookstore and just go buy something without having to think about politics. And unbelievably, he has actually proven the underlying thesis of my book, which is there are places in American life where politics should not be front of mind. This was my same argument that I made against Nike. Nike should try to appeal to everyone instead of slicing and dicing up the population and deciding you don't care about everyone. I think it's insanely dumb of Nike. I think it's dumb of a bookstore. I don't know why, in particular, for a bookstore which exists to allow creative thought and to experience and expose people to ways of thinking that they might not have otherwise been exposed to. That's really the purpose of a book in general. And here is my book, by the way. That's really the entire purpose of a book. Whether you agree or disagree with a book, the idea is you open this up, you challenge your mind with ideas that you may not agree with or that you may even disagree with, and emerge stronger by having considered a wider range of opinions. This book talks about a lot of things that other people are unwilling to talk about. It's why it's selling so many copies right now. It shouldn't be considered remotely offensive. Yet an independent bookstore is so triggered by what is said, evidently, or even what suggests from this cover, that they will not allow it to take place in their venue. I think it's crazy. I think it's crazy that an independent bookstore, not to mention an independent bookstore on 30A, where I would imagine the vast majority of the people who are buying things in that business are actually Republican voters. If you've ever been down and looked at the voting rolls for what happens in the panhandle of Florida, that's one of the most reliable areas for Republican voting in the entire country. So this idiot opens a bookstore and then refuses to allow people who consume and keep his bookstore open to be exposed to ideas that he personally doesn't agree with. It's unbelievable to me. 30A and all of South Walton County is a Republican hotbed. So are the people who come down to Seaside and own homes there. So are the people who own homes in Rosemary. You can vote any way you want. I just find it to be particularly troubling that a bookstore would agree to host me and then cancel me based on my opinions. It's wild to me. This is the world that we live in right now. I don't think it's healthy. I don't think it's good. I don't think it makes sense in any way imaginable.